of people forced to evacuate the Caribbean and Florida. For many, they are in shelters or hotels in different cities and states, some right here in Birmingham. Stress of dealing with that evacuation and the impact of the hurricane can certainly be overwhelming. Fortunately, Dr. Josh Klepo joining us now. Talk about the emotional impact of this hurricane and really any natural disaster or big life-changing events. What are some of the feelings that are normal, that are natural to be feeling?
Well, you said it. This is anything that is really a trauma, and this is an absolute trauma. And I think the thing that gets us into trouble, and it's natural, is we want it to be over. You know, the hurricane passed, let's all get back to normal, and then we realize that we can't. So people can experience everything from feeling kind of shocked, dazed, and confused. Their emotions can swing, so that one minute they can feel great, the next minute they are crying, the next minute they're anxious.
Or angry.
The other thing is processing information can be hard. You think you're paying attention, and it just kind of doesn't stick.
In a fog.
Absolutely. Or even having what we call intrusive thoughts. You're thinking about the evacuation, you're thinking about the hurricane. All of those emotional and cognitive symptoms there, but there's physical ones too.
It's like some people say that depression, all they want to do is sleep, and that seems strange because other people say all I want to do is cry, right?
Absolutely.
It's very different.
I mean, it is not uncommon, it is normal to have headaches, stomach ache, back ache, sleep problems, all of that. Now, none of that feels good.
No.
But it is normal, it doesn't happen to everybody, and there's definitely things that you can do so that it's not quite as bad.
Okay, so what do we do when you notice that maybe you're different than you were pre-hurricane or pre-life-changing event?
The first thing I want you to do, and this sounds a little fluffy, is I want you to give yourself the permission to not feel so good. Because people are sitting there going, I gotta feel great, Allow yourself to have your mini breakdowns, because guess what, you're going to. The second thing is, for some people, talking about it, the event, is very important. Not everybody.
Right.
But getting it off your chest for some people, absolutely critical.
Okay, so when you do that, now what's the importance of things like having a routine and making sure that you are sticking to a schedule or adjusting to a new normal, right?
Well, that's it. That's it, exactly it. Whether you are in a shelter, you're staying at somebody's house, you're in a hotel, having a routine regulates your body. So maybe it's the time you get up in the morning, maybe it's the time you eat breakfast, maybe it's reading a book to your kids. Anything that gets you back on your routine is absolutely critical. And probably, though, one of the most important things is accepting that what is a success is going to be a little bit different. What I mean by that is filing insurance papers. That's a success.
Right.
Starting to clean up your house or being able to go back in, a lot of times we don't think about it that way.
Right.
You need to, so that you can get that reinforcement. You need that reinforcement to keep you going, because your house is not necessarily going to be back in a day.
So for me, a lot of times when I get anxious, it's because I have a long to-do list. So you're saying those small little things that you can check off, just bite-sized chunks, filing the insurance paperwork, cleaning maybe not the whole house, but just this room, give yourself a pat on the back.
It's important, because what it does is it takes this gigantic task,
it makes it manageable.
And what it tells our body and our mind is that we're moving forward.
All right. Thanks so much, Dr. Josh.
Sure,
as always, appreciate it. Hopefully people are on the road to recovery, or maybe even heading home. That'd be great.
Yes.
Sarah?
And we're